Determine the domain and range of the given functions, use interval notation. Recall the domain is a set of all inputs or x values. The range is a set of all outputs or y values. First, we have the graph of y equals x cubed plus 2. To determine the domain, we analyze the graph horizontally or from left to right. We can easily see the graph moves up and down very quickly, but it also continues to move left and right without any holes or breaks, which indicates the domain is all real numbers, which if we were to graph on the x-axis, would be the entire x-axis. Which means any real number can be an input into the cubic function. Using interval notation, the domain is the open interval from negative infinity to positive infinity, which is how we express all real numbers using interval notation. To determine the range, we analyze the graph vertically, or from the bottom to the top, and we can easily see the graph goes down indefinitely and up indefinitely without any horizontal asymptotes, and therefore the range is also all real numbers, which if we were to graph along the y-axis, would be the entire y-axis. Using interval notation, the range is the open interval from negative infinity to positive infinity. And now let's take a look at the graph on the right, which is y equals x squared minus 3. Again, to determine the domain, we analyze the graph horizontally. Notice how the graph does move to the left indefinitely as well as to the right indefinitely without any holes or breaks, which indicates the domain, once again, is all real numbers, which if we were to graph on the x-axis would be the entire x-axis. Again, this indicates any real number can be an input into the given quadratic function. Using interval notation, the domain is the open interval from negative infinity to positive infinity. And now to determine the range, we analyze the graph vertically or from the bottom to the top. Notice the graph does not go down indefinitely. The lowest point on the graph is this point here, the vertex, which is a closed point where the y value is negative 3. And then from there, the graph does go up indefinitely and y approaches positive infinity, which indicates the range is y greater than or equal to negative 3, which if we were to graph on the y-axis, we'd have a closed point at y equals negative 3 and an arrow going up. To express this interval using interval notation, we have the interval from negative 3 to infinity. But in this case, because negative 3 is in the interval, we use a square bracket to the left of negative 3, which indicates the interval is closed on negative 3, again, meaning it includes negative 3, and then we have a rounded parenthesis to the right of infinity. I hope you found this helpful.